to my channel, guys. So in this video, I bring to you another random horror movie review. I stumbled across this movie on Tubi TV called Matango, or The Attack of the Mushroom People. This is a Japanese sci-fi horror movie from 1963, written by Takeshi Kimura, Shinichi Hoshi, Masami Fukushima, and based on the short story The Voice in the Night by William Hope Hodgson, directed by Shiro Handa. This movie focuses on a group of people that get shipwrecked on this mysterious uninhabited island. The island is covered in strange vegetation and unidentifiable species of mushrooms. Eventually, they begin eating those mushrooms to survive, not realizing that eating the mushrooms has some pretty bizarre side effects. And then stuff happens. So this movie plays out like a dream, like this weird dream, like a fever dream, like a strange and surreal nightmare, something along those lines. The visuals in this movie are definitely interesting. You have on one hand like this beautiful and aesthetically pleasing cinematography of this deserted island. On the other hand, you have all these damn mushrooms that looking kind of gross. I don't know, something about mushrooms just like growing in clusters like that just always weirded me out and grossed me the hell out. And then once some other stuff kicks in, the movie does get even more bizarre visually, and at times it's like really strange to look at times it's really kind of gross, and it's also pretty damn creepy. Once I realized what the movie was going to be about, I thought that it was going to be a lot more on like a cheesier side, on almost like a so bad that is good side, but actually the practical effects in this movie are quite good. I feel like they still hold up even to this day, and instead of a really cheesy effect, it actually has a really creepy and strange and bizarre effect, and just really unsettling effect to it. The whole movie overall, especially once those horror elements begin to kick in, feels pretty damn unsettling and strange. It also gets quite intense at times, as the main characters, who are I believe all supposed to be either friends or at least close acquaintances, begin to eventually grow apart, and their friendship or whatever the case kind of relationship they have with each other begins to go out of the window once they get consumed by their distrust of each other and paranoia. There's also a certain amount of jealousy going on between some of them, just a whole lot of stuff that is not a good combination with being stuck somewhere on a deserted island with no way out. The movie is pretty atmospheric as well, and it always has like this element of mystery going on, and the build-up for the horror elements of this movie to kick in is also quite nice. I mean, it does take like a while until you start to see some really strange and bizarre stuff, but even until that point, the movie does keep your interest and it never gets boring. And then once those horror elements do kick in, it really is genuinely creepy. I would say that there were two scenes in particular in this movie towards the end that really, really freaked me out. And on a side note, I'm pretty sure this movie has ruined mushrooms for me. Like, I don't think I want to even look at a mushroom anytime soon, and I'm definitely not eating any mushrooms anytime soon after watching this movie. And in places, it has a surprisingly dark tone to it, and pretty cool practical effects for certain monstrous creatures that they eventually encounter on the island. Now, apparently this movie was almost banned in Japan because some of the practical effects, some of the makeups used on certain actors were resembling victims of the atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which in part I guess is what gives this movie such a dark feel to it and such a dark vibe. One of my problems with this movie though were the characters. All of them just fell really flat to me. Some of them were like really, really obnoxious and annoying, and then the other ones just had no personality whatsoever, and it was kind of hard for me to even differentiate some of them from one another because they just lacked personalities that much. So unfortunately there was like nobody to root for me in this movie, and I don't even know who the hell the main character in this movie was, to be honest. And then the other thing that I had a problem with, but this is really not even a criticism for a movie itself. It's a criticism for the version of this movie that I had watched on Tubi TV. On Tubi TV, the only version available for this movie is an English dub version. And me personally, I hate watching movies dubbed. I would rather watch the movie in the original language and read subtitles, because I feel like when I'm watching the movie dubbed, it takes away some of the atmosphere for the movie, and it just kind of takes me out of the movie a little bit. Is distracting. Not only that, but usually the voiceover acting for the dub versions is horrible. Like, it's way over the top and just ridiculous, and this movie was no exception. Anyways, overall, the movie definitely has a very haunting quality to it. Some of the soundtrack contributes to it as well. It is beautiful to look at. As far as the cinematography is concerned, this deserted island does look really interesting, and all of the bizarre and weird and sometimes gross stuff with mushrooms is also quite interesting to look at as well. So if you like really strange and bizarre movies and haven't seen this one yet, I do feel like it is definitely worth checking out. My rating for Matango or Attack of the Mushroom People would be 8 out of 10. So thank you guys for watching. If you have seen this movie, definitely let me know what did you guys think about it in the comments. Let me know in the comments what are your favorite weird and bizarre movies. Let me know in the comments what are your favorite Japanese weird and bizarre movies with strange and bizarre visuals. And if you are new to this channel and I enjoying my review so far, then definitely go ahead and give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so that you wouldn't miss any future videos, and I will see you in the next one. Okay, bye.